This conference will now be recorded.
Hello, sir.
Hello. Am I audible, Ramna? Voice.
Yes, voice is also good.
Okay.
And visibility is there.
Slide share chestunna.
Hello, కనెక్టర్
ఏ కెమెరా ఆన్ మోడ్ ఇది
సార్ ఏం సార్
ఇలా ప్రెసిడెంట్ రాయి కాదు హెచ్పి లే తప్ప నాని ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದೀರ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಮಾಡಿ
ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಬಂದಿಲ್ಲ
ಇಲ್ಲ ಬಂತು ಬೋತ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೈ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತೇನೆ ಏ ನೋ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ವಿಸಿಬಲ್ ಯು ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ
ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸರ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಓಪನ್ ಆಗ್ತಿದೆ ವೀರ ಹೇಳಿದಕ್ಕೆ ಸ್ಪೀಕರ್ ಕೊಡು
ಜಮೀನ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ 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 ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದಾ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್
ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು ಸರ್ ಇದ್ರ ಮೀಟ್ ಆನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಅವ್ರ ಸ್ಪೀಕರ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಏನೋ ಡಿಸ್ಟರ್ಬ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಸರ್
ಹೆಂಗ ಅನ್ಮ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡೋದು
ಸರ್ ಅದು ಓದ್ತಾ ಸರ್ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಅವ್ರ ಮಾತಾಡ
ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂತು ಬಿಡು ಇಲ್ಲಿ
ಮಾಡಿ
ಲಿಂಕ್ ಸರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಆಡಿಬಲ್ ಅದು ಕನೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಇಟ್ ಜಮೀಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಡಿಬಲ್
ಆಮ್ ಐ ಆಡಿಬಲ್ ಟು ಯು
ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್
ಶಾಲ್ ಐ ಶೇರ್ ದ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ಸ್
ಶೇರ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಪಿಪಿಟಿ ರೆಡಿ
ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಶೇರ್ ದಿ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಪಿಪಿಟಿ ರೆಡಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಲೈಡ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಪುಟ್ ಇಟ್ ದೇರ್ yes I can see your slider oh yes correct screen fine right
okay
right yes okay I'll just introduce you Jevan after that you can try to take over okay
okay
all right sir good afternoon everybody I welcome all the participants to the this final day of 5-day FTP the you know
okay the speaker
is Dr. S.M. Jamil Basha principal Krishna Devaraya engineering college Gutti Anantapur district Andhra Pradesh it's really it's my pleasure for me to invite Dr. Jamil Basha and for this session just to read out the his bio data he is presently working as a principal Cascade Engineering College Gutti and he is a mechanical graduate and a specialization with heat power from JNTU Hyderabad and pursued his PhD in IC engines from JNTU in Anantapur He has put on almost 20 plus of years experience for both UG and PG, and under him some four scholars are pursuing research. He has started his career in 2001 as an assistant professor in the Indian Junior College and elevated to a principal as on today. Yes, into his credit, he has got almost 25 international conferences, papers in various international journals, and he has actively participated in and presented number of journals, papers in national and international platforms. Now, he also got the best award in his research work paper, and he is responsible to for a grant for R&D project named Design and Development of Radio Controlled Hybrids Astrolos UAV for Disaster Rescue Mission, an amount of 50,000 rupees grant he has got it, and later even a grant of 5 lakhs from STTP program. He was the key from AICT New Delhi. Then he has authored a book, like the Proceedings copy as editor, as acted as an editor, ICETME 2018, which is a Springer lecture notes mechanical engineer. Okay, he has received the best researcher in metal matrix composites and optimization techniques organized by Research Under Lateral Axis Awards, RULA 2018, Tirchi, Tamil Nadu. Okay, so it's a really wonderful graduate, I can see. The professor is going to address CFD and then its applications today. Hope all the researchers will be or the aspirants will be delighted to go through this presentation. Thank you, and on behalf of our team BITM Bellary Mechanical Engineering, I welcome all the participants and the speaker, Dr. S. Jamil Basha. Sir, over to you.
Thank you. Thank you, Professor Venkatramana, for your kind introduction. Thank you very much. Shall I start?
Yeah, please start.
Good afternoon, everyone. Hope that all of you are doing well in this pandemic time, and home all of you are fit and fine at your respective houses. And I sincerely thank BITM for giving this opportunity, where we are in a closed door since 2 to 3 months, and this is one of the teaching learning processes. All the teachers are well versed that we should be continuously engaged in these teaching learning processes. And my topic of today's interest, you are already engaged since 4-5 days, between 2 to 3. I hope this is the last day for every one of you. Am I audible? Hello, am I audible? So today is the last day, and my topic of today's interest is computational fluid dynamics. And it is what I can do is, within this span of time, I can only give an overview of what computational fluid dynamics is. And the syllabus that was framed is something for 70 to 80 hours by the universities. Putting all in a nutshell for 1 hour is something, a difficult task that was given to me, and not even a single equation I can derive regarding computational fluid dynamics in a 1 hour. But what I can do is, in this particular time, is I can just give you what computational fluid dynamics is. Majority of you people might be knowing about this particular CFD, and still I can provide you a better insights. My lecture is going to target PG students as well as researchers who are pursuing their PhDs in the respective universities. So therefore, I welcome every one of you for this computational fluid dynamics and overview. Let me tell you how it has taken off in India, because CFD actually was India, the pioneering work was done under Professor V. Ganeshan. And my guide, Professor Rajagopal, is the first person to take up this computational fluid dynamics course in IIT Madras in 92 to 95 under Professor V. Ganeshan. I hope everyone of all the mechanical engineering fraternity knows Professor V. Ganeshan very well. And my guide have taken up that particular CFD work, and he has continued in IIT Madras. Then I have continued his work further in 2004 onwards. So in coming to you know, this computational fluid dynamics aspect, screen, you know, I was unable to change this. Oh, this computational fluid dynamics, as I already said, that you know, I cannot even, you know, derive a Navier-Stokes equations within given time of one hour. So therefore, let us look into the basic fundamental aspects of computational fluid dynamics. The index, just I am reading for every one of your reference, and the first one is an introductory part. Then we go for the applications. Then we see why CFD is, and then we go for what are the various aspects of divisions of CFD, and then we go for what are the job opportunities that are promising in CFD and all those things. So therefore, kindly listen to this particular aspect, and I hope by end of my class, every one of you will at least know how CFD, you know, performs and how CFD goes. Computational fluid dynamics aspect, let me tell you that you know, we can divide the CFD into two categories. Generally, the researchers, how they go ahead in CFD is that first, the student takes the CFD code, might be a fluent or might be a star CD or different, what you call, tools that we have in the market. And then we start working onto the codes directly, where it requires a simple you know, skill. We operate that particular code and we go for some results. We tabulate those results, we interpret those results, and we go for, you know, presenting those results in YOOCs. But it is not a correct methodology of you know, approach towards the CFD. A computational fluid dynamics requires a thorough understanding of the physics and chemistry of fluid mechanics, heat transfer, and the fundamental equations. What is a what you call mass momentum and continuity equations, and how these mass momentum continuity equations goes for you know, developing some Navier-Stokes equations. Then what is the modeling, how discretization takes place, and how modeling helps in you know, discretization. Then we go for modeling of a turbulence. Then we go for all these, you know, aspects will come into picture automatically one after the other. Fundamentally, we need to know what you know, the CFD course is, rather than going to a CFD tool. So I urge all of you not to directly rush for a CFD tool, because CFD tools are conveniently available in a market, and students do have an affinity directly to go for operating a tool. It requires a mere skill, that's it. But if you want to know the insights of that particular tool, it is mandatory that you should have a what you call a fundamental, thorough fundamental knowledge of computational fluid dynamics. And my you know, slides helps you how the takeoff will go for a CFD course. Then I go for a CFD code. First coursework, then we go for a code, and then we go for the applications and all those things. So coming to this particular aspect, we now look into what computational fluid dynamics is. Since starting, I have this particular slide. CFD is the analysis of system evolving fluid flow heat transfer and associated phenomena such as chemical reactions by means of a computer based simulations. So before you learn into dip into CFD, the demanding aspect of the CFD is having a fundamental knowledge of heat transfer as well as fluid flow. So we need to first look into the problem in a particular domain, and we need to categorize whether all these fluid mechanics or something. There is a fundamental problem in the syllabus also, that in the entire UG course we will have fluid mechanics, say a one dimensional fluid flow might be in case of a fluid mechanics or in case of a heat transfer. But if you go for a PG, the entire thing one dimensional aspects will change into a three dimensional aspects. So what I feel is a particular student to be apprised both regarding one dimensional approach as well as three dimensional approach or two dimensional approach in UG itself, which will give him a better idea of one dimensional, two dimensional, three dimensional approaches. So therefore, here it is a bit confusing activity that entire CFD course follow a two dimensional or three dimensional. It doesn't go for a linear relationship, rather it goes for a non-linear relationships, and it is entirely dependent on two dimensional and three dimensional and multi-dimensional flows. So therefore, here a particular student feels always it is difficult for him to attack the CFD, but it is not like that. So every student nowadays, the fundamental equations that which are there in the fluid mechanics are not now derived. It was not derived now. It was derived back, way back 100 or 150 years ago. All those equations are before 100 and 150 years ago. Even heat transfer equation, fundamental equation, Fourier laws, all those particular laws which have been derived are there since 100 years ago. But what we are doing now is synergizing these fundamental equations, might be in two dimensional or in a three dimensional format, into a computer based simulations. So converting that particular equations into a three dimensional equation with the suitable simulations is computational fluid dynamics. Is I hope every one of you are clear what fundamentals of this what CFD defines. The technique is very powerful and spans wide range of industrial and non-industrial applications. You know that nowadays it has become a mandatory that the simulations nowadays goes with both at industry as well as non-industry level. The fundamental simulations are very, very important, and it is a it gives the accuracy of a solution. It saves a lot of. We come across the uses of CFD in the coming slides. It is a powerful tool to solve horrendous PDEs and integral equations. Computational fluid dynamics, we can convert these PDEs.
Sorry to interrupt you, sir. Sir.
Yes.
Sir, kindly remove the ad at the bottom of the system, sir. On the screen, it is displaying an ad, sir. Kindly remove it, sir, please.
No, right now we don't have any ad here. Right now it is.
Yeah, something it is showing. It is showing, sir. Now it is gone, sir. Oh, okay, sir. Okay, fine. Continue, sir.
Yeah. So all partial differential equations and integral equations are to be converted into a simulation tools. So if you come for a research, then it becomes a really cumbersome task for every one of you to convert these partial differential equations into the language of a computer, which can be given in terms of a C language or into a Fortran language. That is a different aspect. But anyhow, we need to come across the basic fundamental principles of the PDEs as well as the integral equations also. Next. Physics of CFD, the aspects of flow is governed by three fundamental. Every one of you people might be knowing this, because the aspects of flow is governed by all the three equations, might be mass equation, might be momentum equation, which is given by Newton's second law, and energy equation, energy is conserved, all these are the fundamental principles of flow, and these principles are expressed in terms of basic mathematical equations in their integral form or in their partial differential form. Then we discretize these equations into an algebraic form and we come across the results at various time and space domains. So the transition of computational fluid dynamics goes something like this. I will put it in somewhat easier language because all is printing material that is available on a slide. First, a PDE or integral equations are there. Those PDEs and integral equations are discretized and make into algebraic form, and that algebraic forms with suitable boundary conditions and all those things, that algebraic forms, we can solve the equations with the help of different mathematical methods, and we can come across the solution for the problem in different time and space domains. This is a fundamental categorization of a fluid mechanics. A particular flow may be inviscid flow or viscous flow. With inviscid flows are further divided into compressible flows and incompressible flows. We have viscous flows, we can see laminar and turbulent flows. Then we can have flows through internal, that means pipes and walls. Then we go for an external aerofoil and ship applications. History of computational fluid dynamics. In 1960s, researchers are operating with two approach word. That means they used to interact only with regard to an experiment, and then we go for a theory. Theory and experiment goes to hand to hand in 1960s. But here, with the advent of computers, of high-end computers nowadays, you have seen what is the hard disk capacity and what is the RAM capacity in nowadays computers, and all these three-dimensional approaches have come into pictures with a huge hardware requirement of a computer. So therefore, now it is a three-dimensional approach that has been coined with the CFD. So earlier, it was only a theory as well as a practical. But the problem here is theory and a practical means whatever the theory is there, you look into the practice. But it is the best methodology. Everyone admits it. But going for a practical for each and every applications is quite different, right? So therefore, it is a very hardening to every one of us that we go for we go for experimentation for every time, all right? So high performance computing hardware and the introduction of user-friendly interfaces has raised the demand of CFD nowadays. So therefore, these computational fluid dynamics have taken larger role to be played. It has come in between a computer. It has come in between a theory to that of a practice. Now, in 1960, it says that a theory is something that nobody believes except the man proposing the theory. And the experiment is something everybody believes and except the person doing that particular experiment, because he himself doesn't believe these are the results. So now the CFD has given a synergized approach between a pure experiment and a pure theory, and the CFD comes in between. Computational fluid dynamics demands a thorough knowledge of fluid mechanics, a thorough knowledge of heat and mass transfer, then it requires, of course, a fundamental physics and mathematics. So with these, and also it requires one thing that I would like to add upon in computational fluid dynamics, it also have it should also have a thorough knowledge of he should also have a thorough knowledge of a basic programming language in a computer. So that particular aspect I would like to add upon. The CFD demands one or the other fundamental computing language, might be anything of your own convenience. So therefore, fluid mechanics, heat and mass transfer, physics and mathematics, these are the required subjects for computational fluid dynamics. We go across the fundamentals as such in computational fluid dynamics. It goes for, as I have said, that basic philosophy, basic fundamentals, fluid flow equations, mathematical behavior of the equations, basic discretization equations. Might be we go for a discretization with the two different methodologies. One is finite difference method, and then we go for a finite volume method. The finite difference method now can be taken a form of finite element method also. Then we go for these finite difference and finite volume method goes for a transformation of a grid and generations, transformations and grid generations. Then we go for some mathematical technique, might be LU decomposition technique or any mathematical techniques which are there to solve the equation. Then we go for the applications of CFD. Now, significance of the CFD. Nowadays, all the UG courses I'm sorry for the disturbance. Nowadays, all the universities has introduced CFD as one of the elective for the BTech courses. CFD has replaced the build and test models. CFD has replaced build and test methods, making simulations inexpensive. It is.
Hey.
Hello. CFD has replaced build and test methods.
Yes, sir. Audible, sir. You can continue.
Yeah. CFD has replaced build and test methods, making simulations inexpensive. One example that I would like to quote, in this particular aspect is the simulations are made very inexpensive nowadays by using CFD. If you look into aerodynamic applications, especially where we have a larger orbital velocities, the spacecraft leaving one atmosphere to another atmosphere, going for experimentation of this kind, a huge wind tunnels, everybody of you know what wind tunnel experiments are, and it is a larger time consuming and a very expensive kind of an activity. Now CFD is the solution for that particular problem. It is less time consuming, predicting the real conditions with comprehensive information. CFD has the ability to analyze experiment difficult or impossible to perform, especially an IC engine applications which are there nowadays are very impossible to perform, because if you want to find the flow field velocities which are there inside the piston valve, it is very difficult for us to find out what is happening inside the velocity vectors inside the piston valve. Try to understand, I am speaking about the piston and the valve which is there. So therefore, CFD is the solution for it. CFD has an ability to analyze experiments difficult or impossible to perform. So therefore, CFD, again, it provides a huge database. The CFD, the results of the CFD can be tabulated and it can be put as a library for a reference for any of the person who want to do the later investigation also. With this particular figure, I can explain you what the significance of CFD is. If you see this figure, you will come to know, there is a shape optimization of a T-junction. there is a T junction here, right? This is a T junction, and the amount of flow of air coming here has been divided into two parts. So generally, with this particular orientation of a figure, what we can expect is the amount of flow of air which is coming here, air flow, will go into the branch outlet. 90% of the, with this particular configuration of the figure, 90% of the flow is going outside through branch outlet, but only 10% is expected, right? 10 or 5% of, because there is an opening here also. It is a marginal opening, so obviously you can less amount of flow, you know, a if we want to optimize this, if we want to have a control over the flow of the fluid through the branch outlet, you can see the CFD results. 30% is coming out here, 50% is coming out here, and the third figure is 80%. So therefore, you can have a control, not even 30, 50 or 80%. You can even, you know, optimize, or you can even, you know, this particular optimize, you can have a shape optimization of 30%, 31%, 32%, 33%. Likewise, right from 30% to whatever the percentage, up to 100% you want, you can continuously go for optimizing the T junction. That experimentally, if you want to do, for 30% you have to take result, for 31% again you have to take result, for 32% you have to take. Likewise, you have to continuously change the shape of a T junction and collect the information experimentally. But with the simulated results, it becomes very easier for a particular person to come across you know, what amount of branch outlet, amount of air that is going to be you know, going out of the branch. So this is one of the fundamental importance of using CFD. Now this is another, you know, application or significance of I cannot call you this as an application, but significance of CFD. This is a bowl. What I am showing here is a piston bowl, and you can see it is a piston bowl with, it is a Mexican hat piston bowl, and this piston bowl volume, and further, you know, piston is extended here. This is the entire piston volume that is being shown on a screen, and this particular bowl is connected into different planes. I have named it as a K1, K2, K3, K4 and K5 planes. Let us suppose K1 will start from the bottom of the piston bowl, K2 somewhat higher than K1, K3 somewhat, you know, this position, and K4 somewhat up, and K5 again onto the top of the piston bowl. This piston bowl has a very significant effect onto the swept volume, and total volume can be controlled with this piston bowl only, and everywhere, every, you know, IC engine expert knows about it. And with this computational fluid dynamics, you can have a control, and you can see the amount of velocity vectors and how the air is performing inside that particular piston bowl at that particular plane. This is a computational you know, domain, and this is the figure that is obtained. If you just turn it, a top view has been shown onto the screen, and it is very easier for you to analyze. And here there are you know, some thick aspects of flow, and there are very light aspects of flow, and all those things. So therefore, we can analyze, and we can have the changed velocity vectors, we can change the amount of air entry into the system, and all those things. These, we cannot do it manually. The only thing that we can do is with the computational fluid dynamics. So therefore, CFD comes for our rescue to have an important information which is there, which cannot be practically known to every one of us. Next is limitations of CFD. And coming to the limitations of CFD, you know that, you know, every you know, every application of engineering have limitations. Likewise, we have the limitations for computation of fluid dynamics also. The consistency and accuracy of the predictor results are questioned. If you see the results of a simulation, I don't believe, being a guide for my PhD students, I don't believe the results that are there coming out of the simulations, because simulations are not, unless those results are validated, we cannot take the simulations into account. So therefore, consistency and accuracy also, because if you see the discretization process entirely goes with the approximations. The fundamental knowledge of finite volume or a finite difference method says that the solution can be acquired only at the nodal points of a particular domain. So therefore, we divide a particular aspect into different nodal points. So obviously, you cannot predict the actualness or correctness of the solutions. So therefore, the consistency is questioned, as well as accuracy of the solutions is also questioned. All the basic dynamic codes run with their own assumptions and restrictions. You know, all the fundamental codes might be Kiva, or might be Fluent, might be StarCD, or OpenFOAM, whichever are there, they have their own assumptions and restrictions. To say some assumptions, we assume in all the codes, in all the fluid dynamic codes, might be, the people who are operating it knows better, that in all the codes, we assume the Lewis number as equal to 1. Lewis number can never be equal to 1 practically. Lewis number do lie between 0.5 to 0.8. But for ease of the calculations, we always go for assuming Lewis number is equal to 1. So this is the fundamental assumption that we have taken into account. One of the restrictions, if I say one of the restrictions, simulation of IC engine, the scalar dissipation rate fluctuations, SDRF, these fluctuations are ignored. Though they are present practically, these are ignored. So therefore, all the fluid dynamic codes have their own assumptions and restrictions. So we cannot have the accuracy of the solution with these assumptions and restrictions. But practically, whatever you get, that is authentic, not the simulated results, right? The solution predictor with the simulations are active, but error can be minimized, because we have a set of solutions with us, and those if we minimize those particular errors, then, which is very important for the engineering applications, if you are able to minimize the errors of the solutions, then it is okay and we can go ahead with the CFD. This particular slide, I have picked it from Anderson Jr., a competition, the textbook which I always prefer for computational fluid dynamics, which gives us a roadmap for CFD. I repeat the title: Computational Fluid Dynamics Basics by Anderson. This is one of the important textbooks I have put down in the last slides also, for those students who are looking for CFD. It might be very, very important for you. Fundamental physical principles, which are mass, momentum, and energy equations, are converted into models of flow. Here you can see the direct lead to integral equations in conservation form, fixed finite control volume, moving finite control volume. In this particular textbook, he has divided into a particular control volume, and then the conservation equations and all the above physical principles are applied onto those particular control volume, and he integrated that particular area, and then he has gone for the solution of it. So if you come for E as well as F, this is you know, fixed finite control volume and moving finite control volume. Here directly leads to integral equations, and discretization using integral equation is nothing but a finite volume method. And if you come down here, fixed infinite small volume and moving infinite small volume, these two are directly leads to the partial differential equations. If you see these G and H, these the governing equations are the discretization process is being taken by finite difference method or finite element method. Then we go for writing governing equations for the fluid flow, which is the outcome of mass is a continuity equation. Mass is conserved in continuity equation, and momentum equation you can get from Newton's second law, as well as energy equation you can get once energy is conserved. So after getting these governing equations, forms of these equations particularly suitable. Now we convert these equations, might be continuity, momentum, and energy equations, using suitable mathematical techniques. We have larger mathematical techniques with us, and those mathematical techniques can be applied and convert these governing equations. Then we go for getting solutions of this particular equation. Next is applications of CFD. CFD has huge applications in all the branches of engineering disciplines: aerospace engineering, automotive engineering, biomedical, chemical, HVAC, hydraulics, marine engineering, power generation, and sports. All these are the various walks of life where computational fluid dynamics is exhaustively used nowadays. And if you come for this, I have already said in my earlier slide that aerospace engineering is one of the highest usage of CFD is there in aerospace engineering. High angle of attack. If you see this particular figure, these simulations will give us the high angle of attack re-entry simulation. These are the figures that has been picked up from NASA, and hypersonic CFD space shuttle simulations. This is a space shuttle which has been shown on slide. This is a space shuttle, and in 90s, where Kalpana Chawla have died due to the thermal brick failure, with the velocities of this particular space shuttle entering from one atmosphere to another atmosphere where it has been failed, and a lot of works have been done, hypersonic CFD space shuttle simulations. This is one of the greatest works that the flow can be divided into three types. Actually, one is subsonic flows, it is subsonic flows or a sonic flows or supersonic flows. And now we have gone, the advent of the technology, we have gone for the hypersonic flows. So simulating these hypersonic flows, which can impossible by practically doing it, can be done with the help of the hypersonic CFD simulations. This simulations will give us the amount of accumulation of heat, the amount of velocity with which these particular space shuttles are moving, what is the orbital velocities, what are the Mach numbers that are to be taken into account, and etc. Automotive engineering, it is a huge application can be done for automotive engineering, especially using CFD. You can see the simulation of underhood flow, aerodynamic, all the vehicles nowadays, you might have been seen how the shapes are continuously changing in the starting. The flow that has been shown here is the simulation of underhood flow. The velocity with which this car is moving and the relative velocity of air that is entering into particular simulation into, because here the fan will be there, a fan will be provided, lot many obstacles is there, and the flow has been divided. It goes and touches the radiator part, it cools the engine, and then the flow of these red lines will further flow, and some of the air goes under the bonnet and it leaves the particular area. Then there is the simulation of air conditioning system inside the car also can be done very effectively, because the air duct, the ducts which are available inside the car, because the entity itself is different. We are going for cooling a particular space that is there inside a car. We can have the probable normal distribution from all the three or four ducts which are being provided inside the cars to reach to the public, to reach to the people who are sitting inside the car. And here is the CFD simulations of the Formula One car. But we know that all the cars which are moving with the higher velocities, especially in Formula One, with the velocities it's supposed to go, and what is the heat that has been generated in this particular CFD simulations can be seen very effectively here, right? One second, I'm just taking it. Yeah. And next is a temperature distribution in an IC engine, internal combustion engine. All blue part here is the amount of air that has been taken into the system, and then it is leaving the system along with the combustion products. The blue part, which is there, is the amount of fresh air that has been taken into the system, right? And if it is an SI engine, here it mixed with petrol, or if it is a CA engine, the charge is being taken into the system and it is get compressed. And this yellow area which is there is the amount of flue gases or the amount of combustible gases which is leaving, and you can see the temperature, which is 2269.57 degrees centigrade. So this is a simulation. Video simulation is also there with me, but I cannot show you right now. And this is how the amount of air or charge entering into a system. This is the raise in temperatures within the cylinder volume can be very evident in this particular slide. Next, we go for the engine simulation. This simulation part here, this engine has been divided. A meshing has been done. It is not used for a simulation. In this is a computational fluid dynamics, sometimes called as a colorful dynamics also. This is the entire engine part has been meshed, has been divided for the analysis purpose, because you cannot have a total engine to be simulated. So whatever the happens, it happens inside the system. But you can divide this into a finite elements, or meshing can be done onto this particular engine that has been shown. Next is these are the valve arrangements. A lot many PhD works, or a lot many people are doing works onto the valve arrangements also. If you see the amount of air entering into the system, it is blue, and you can see the amount of temperature in Kelvin, 293.15 degrees. The amount of air entering through this particular inlet valve, and once the combustion was done, it is leaving the through outlet valve, and you can see the temperature has been raised up to 934.5 degree Kelvin. The next one is catalytic converters. I hope every one of you know what catalytic converter is. Catalytic converters are the devices which are used in the tailpipes of the engines, and they are very much used to regulate the amount of SOx, NOx and COx which are present inside the tailpipe. And you can see the same here, NOx, HC emissions, CO emissions, and all these can be controlled with the help of these catalytic converters. Here, this is a simulation part that has been done, how much the thickness of this converter should be there, and what should be the amount of air or amount of exhaust gases which are coming from the tailpipe should enter, and what should be the volume of this particular tailpipe, and all those things we can have a simulation. Next is the biomedical engineering. Recently, I have attended one of the conferences, an international conference, and one of the speakers is a professor from IISc Bangalore, where he was emphasizing the very, very importance of this biomedical engineering with mechanical. Though he is in mechanical engineering in IISc Bangalore, he was shifted to a biomedical engineering branch where he is doing a lot of simulations for transient, flow, the amount of air that has been taken by a particular person. If you can see more these kind of applications, you can view with the pulmonologist nowadays, which is a hot topic during a COVID days. Transient airflow pattern in lung model, because the lungs are the other forms of the analogy can be driven with an engine. The inhaling capacity of the engine, right, is nothing but the lungs simulation. The amount of breath or the amount of volume of air that is taken into the system is very, very important, because greater is the volume of air, greater healthy is the particular person. So therefore, the simulations of lungs nowadays can be very effectively done using these computational fluid dynamics. Likewise, cardiac simulations also, you can see a particular here the heart has been divided into number of components, and we can see the working of all these four valves and the amount of air entering from coming from lungs, amount of blood that is going through veins and arteries, and all those things. Chemical processing industries, you can see how the CFD comes for a rescue, for a shallow water capping methodology, helping to mitigate the flame gas risk in the industries. And in this particular slide, you can see the CFD laboratory atomizer varying with the inlet pressure. The entire above green area shows us the variation of the density, and the lower area shows us the variation of a Mach number. So therefore, change the pressure at the top A, B, C, D, and E. The pressures have been changed. P is equal to 6 bar, P is equal to 11 bar, and 16 bar, 21 bar, 26 bar. The different pressures are different pressures. We can check upon the amount of density of the atomizer, and we can also see the Mach number variation with respect to the pressures. Next. This is a heating, ventilation, and air conditioning application, where you can see the CFD, how CFD is used to predict the behavior of the contaminant within the room. The CFD analysis capable enables you to predict the behavior of the contaminant within the room. We know that contaminant should be controlled within particular room, and to get a control over the room, these contaminants are needed to be taken out of that particular room, which comes under the air conditioning or ventilation air conditioning system. And here the lower figure will show the air flow speed efficiency. The flow of air within a particular room should be uniform, and should see where the concentration of the flow is. Rather than taking into total room into account, we take the simulated results, and we can work onto it. Then we can see the throw of air is within the room is made uniform. This is an interesting slide which I have right now in front of you. Here, this comes under the applications of hydraulics, CFD applications towards hydraulics, and gas water mixture inlet. You can see the water is entering with some velocity into a inlet through this particular inlet, and here there is a separator for both the gas as well as water. Water is connected to the other way, and gas is collected in a compressor. So therefore, here this particular simulation shows us how gas and water mixture are separated from each other. Gas can be separated and sent to a compressor, and water can be collected in the collectors. Penstock simulations, you know where these penstocks are used. They are used in the dams, and you can see the amount of flow through this particular, this particular penstock, right? So it is quite important because this goes for a turbine directly. Here it is for we need to place four turbines under these four penstocks, and the amount of flow of water should be uniform in all these four penstocks, because more amount of flow will be obviously seen in this particular penstock. If you go farther, the amount of the mass quantity of the quantity of water entering into the penstock will reduce, further it will reduce. This should not be the case. In case of power generation, all these four penstocks should be uniformly loaded with water, and these particular valves play a vital role. That amount of water that is entering into the penstocks is controlled with these particular valves. You can see valve 1 here, valve 2 and valve 3. The rest of the water is made to flow through this particular penstocks. So therefore, the simulation will give us an idea how exactly amount of water is divided among four penstocks, because I have already said that the amount of water which is entering into all the penstocks should be equal, because all the turbines should run parallelly. Next, this is the valve arrangement which is there, how valves are closing. One valve is closed, there are two entrances here, flow is coming into this particular area. This is a valve, and if you want to close the flow from towards the right side, the flow, this valve can be lowered, and the flow is made to pass onto the top of this particular slide. So therefore, the simulation, because it cannot be transparent if unless CFD gives us the results. So therefore, we can see the amount of valve opening and how exactly the flow is moving. You can see the red area, because lesser is the opening here. We need to in CFD, interpretation of the results is quite important. Documenting the results and interpreting the results is one of the greatest expertise which is required in CFD. You can see red area is being seen here. Amount of air which is flowing through this particular domain is higher because there is a friction that has been raised here. There is a lesser gap between these two particular valve and to that of this particular gate. So obviously, due to friction, the raise in temperature is also there. So likewise, we need to control each and every parameter. Raise in temperature is not the criteria in the gating activity, especially in fluid mechanics. So therefore, how to simulate this and get this red area into blue area so that the amount of this hot area, the red area, can be reduced. How exactly this needed to be designed, we can have through the simulations. Next is the application in sports. We have larger applications of CFD are there nowadays in sports. Once it has been viewed by the third umpire, the replay and all those activities, once the player completes his sports or his game, let us suppose a football or a basketball, everyone goes to the dressing room and look back into their particular videos that they have played. If it is a football, the amount of energy that is, or the amount of force with which the ball should be kicked into, what it should be a quantified amount. And at the same time, if you kick a particular ball and how exactly it reaches the goal and how it takes the shape, the simulated results will definitely help him to take into cognizance that how he has to apply, how he has to play for his game. So in sports nowadays, you know, these CFD applications are very vital and has been used. And especially this racing activity, if you see there, as the racer goes, the amount of relative velocity obviously is doubled, and you can see his head area have become red, and velocity is greater here. So therefore, how to reduce this particular velocity? You know, all the entire vehicle doesn't face that velocity, only the head portion is facing more velocity. This is something serious, and we have to look into this particular area, and we have to reduce the velocity, which is 30 meters per second, let us suppose. So therefore, these simulated results will help a particular sports person to visualize, to analyze himself, and how exactly he has to manage with his sports. Next is, we come for a discretization techniques. Discretization is dividing a particular aspect into a finite volume and a finite element method. Previously, we used to have a finite difference method. Now it has been taken off and it has been named as a finite element method. Every, you know, it is there in all BTech courses, finite element method. But we don't find, unfortunately, finite volume method in all the universities. Finite element method, the discretization of the partial differential equation is called as a finite element method. If you go for a finite volume method, the discretization of the integral equations is called as a finite volume method. All the CFD generally follows the discretization using finite volume methods, majority of them. What is the finite difference method? This is known to everyone. It is a basic fundamental concept that partial derivatives of the governing equations are replaced by the approximate algebraic coefficients. Algebraic coefficients are expressed strictly in terms of flow fields. Now the partial differential equations have discretized. This method of discretization is called as a finite difference method. Then we go for finite element method. FEM again is a sister concern of finite difference method only, right? The only linearity and non-linear equations, more non-linear equations are addressed in finite difference method, and less non-linear equations are addressed in finite element method. Once we go for a quadratic expression, then we go for applying any of the Fourier series or Chebyshev polynomials and mathematical methods, and then we come for a computational domain and approximation is there. Then we go for the theory of the finite has been developed initially and structured stress analysis. More of this finite element method is given more towards the design people rather than the thermal engineering. Then we go for finite volume method. I already said that majority of the simulations uses the finite volume method, where we go for integrating for integral equations, has been discretized, then converted into an algebraic equations to suitable mathematical models. Then those algebraic equations, we can get the solutions using these finite volume methods. Next is, this is a fundamental equation where rate of change of flow in the control volume with respect to the time. I don't think right now it is very important for every one of you. Then we go for, because it is a finite volume method, I am bit more into this finite volume method. If you see this particular equation, this particular theory, which says that physical phenomena are complex and non-linear, because all the turbulent applications are non-linear in its forms. The most of the popular solution procedures, as I have said, that the linear, all these equations are needed to be converted using suitable mathematical methods. You can see a lot many mathematical methods are there. There are TDMA techniques, there are the LU decomposition techniques, and all these techniques are used to convert to discretize into partial differential, partial integral equations into algebraic equations. Then we come across the codes, commercial codes used for the techniques such as the store, lot many algorithms or codes can be used, and these results can be got using the different mathematical techniques. Now, how the CFD code works? CFD codes are structured around the numerical algorithm that can tackle the fluid flow problem. CFD packages include sophisticated user interfaces to input problem parameters to examine the results. You know, let me tell you, nowadays the CFD codes are very much handy, are very much user friendly. The cost of one pack might be, one of the licenses that we have recently purchased for Fluent is, it goes for 6 lakhs, and a good laptop, the configuration of a laptop again goes for 1.5 lakhs. So totally you can, for your particular application, you can have a simulation desk only at a cost of 6.5 to 7 lakhs. I hope colleges can easily purchase, and we can have a different kind of environment where all the PG and PhD students are working on this particular software, right? So it can be done within 7 to 8 lakhs on all those packages which are there. CFD packages include sophisticated user interface to input problem parameters and to examine the results. And all the CFD codes, now we are into the code part where, how a particular code is divided into. It is divided into pre-processor, solver, and a post-processor, right? So pre-processor and a solver and a post-processor. What pre-processor is? Let me go for the insights of pre-processor, solver, and a post-processor. The pre-processor tells us about the definition of a geometry, grid generation, how definition of a fluid properties, physical and chemical phenomena to be happening inside, specifications, and boundary conditions. I tell you with one of these examples, the figure that has been shown on the particular slide is a computational mesh of a hemispherical ball. These hemispherical ball, right? This is a pre-processor part. You can draw this particular hemispherical ball using any CAD software, right? Can be done, can be used with the using any CAE package, and that can be imported, then can be meshed, which is the solver part, then can be sent for the result analysis. So this is a computational mesh of a hemispherical ball. This is a computational mesh of a tetrahedral, this is the computational mesh of a Mexican hat ball with the lip. Will lip mean the sense here you can have a control on this particular part has been chiseled inside a particular piston. So this is called as Mexican hat ball with the lip. The other one is a Mexican hat ball. You can see a simple CAD figure, right, which can be either drawn in a Gambit or IDEAS or Nastron. You can do this solid modeling here, and you can draw this particular figure, right? And you can see in this particular figure, it has been divided, it has been meshed. It can be meshed using hypermesh, or it can be meshed using any meshing softwares which is available in the market. And this particular piston is divided into hexahedral and tetrahedral elements. You just see the amount of control volumes that are there. It is 5,73,100 control volumes. A huge division of control volumes has been done, right? And you can have control on each and every volume. This is the beauty of CFD, that if your number of control volumes, more are the number of control volumes, more is the control onto this particular happenings inside. Here that has been shown onto the slide. More are the number of cells, better is the solution accuracy. So if you divide into more number of cells, you can have more number of good amount of fair amount of accuracy is expected. And accuracy of the solution, cost of cost in terms of necessary computing hardware and calculation time are dependent onto the fineness of the grid. If the grid is fine, the amount of the hardware requirements depends on the grid only. So therefore, whether it is a fine grid or it is a coarse grid, there it demands more amount of computational time. It puts more amount of load onto the hardware of the computer. So finer mesh is recommended in the areas where variation occur. Now, if you see the earlier figure, I can show you. Here, the meshing, here, you know, this particular portion is used, we have used a soft mesh here, fine mesh rather, and the coarse mesh can be used where there is no larger variations in the part. So all this piston area, you know, we can see a coarse mesh, and all this area we can see a fine mesh, right? So meshing again is divided into two types. One is tetrahedron mesh and hexahedron mesh. Preferably we mesh it with a hexahedron because more amount of information can be revealed using hexa mesh rather than a tet mesh. Now if you go for an industry, 50% of the time in industry is spent in defining domain geometry and grid generation. One of my students is working in the industry where he only draws a CAD figures. He is working for Mercedes-Benz and he continuously develops only a CAD figure. That means pre-part processing part only. He has no control over solver. He has no understanding of a post-processor also. So you will hardly find a particular person who is having the knowledge of all the three. That means a pre-processor, solver, and a post-processor. Industry won't recommend such kind of persons. Rather, it requires expertise only in one of the other three important categories of the CFD. Might be a pre-processor, or might be a solver, or might be a post-processor, right? So therefore, nowadays we have a larger meshing tools in industry. We have a pattern, Hypermesh is there, IDS is there. Then a pre-processor also give access to the library, right? So all the results of the pre-processor can be nowadays can be very much used, which are stored in the library for having special physical and chemical process models. Solvers. These solvers are very, very important. They convert, they discretize the flow equations, the governing equations. These solvers helps us to know, the better understanding of a pre-processes. You can see approximation of the unknown flow variables by means of a simple function. Formal integration of the governing equations is done here. Then we go for a discretization of that one. We apply either a finite volume or a finite different method in a discretization. Then we go for a solution of the algebraic equations. The solution of the algebraic equation itself, we have mathematical methods are there. Everyone are well versed with the mathematical methods, might be in the second year of UG courses or in the higher, in the application of the UG or PG programs. You can have a larger, the subject itself is there in PG for mathematical, separate mathematical methods, right? TDMA techniques are there, relaxation, different relaxation methods you can look into. And we have, one second, advertisement is there. And alternating direction, implicit methods, gradient search method, all these are the mathematical methods with which we can come onto the solutions for the algebraic equations. Next, we go for a post-processing. Post-processing is an art. I call it as an art. The result that has been got from a solver, now it has to be presented in terms of a colorful dynamics, right? So therefore, domain geometry and display grids, vector plots, lines and shaded contour plots, these are view manipulations. View manipulation is very, very important. Color post, post-script output animations of flow, which makes all the people very interesting, right? So here you can see one of the velocity vectors which are there. As I have said that it is a semi-spherical bowl that has been shown, and you have K3 plane. I have taken right from the starting K1, K2, K3. I have divided a particular bowl into five different varieties of planes, and here it is a K3 plane. And you can have a view manipulation. If you open up this particular velocity vectors, you can see these velocity vectors, and you can analyze where the amount of hot spots are there. Generally, hot spots are not recommendable in a particular volume of the air. So therefore, it goes for self-ignition of the air, so which is not recommended. Then this is the results that has been this is the post-processing results. If you see the K4 plane, it is a bit above the K3 plane, and the K5 plane, it is again above the K4 plane, and you can see the amount of the what you call velocity vectors is slowed down and is going towards the top of a piston bow. Next is temperature contours. This particular figure will show you the temperature contour, right? And then the lower one is a pressure contours. These are the different contours that we can show how a temperature has been divided inside a particular piston. This is a piston, and the amount of air which is coming here, the inlet air, you can see the blue portion is there. So obviously you will have less amount of occupancy of air, and once combustion was done, the other area is being the other area we have larger amount of temperature distribution. So we can have a control under the temperature controls, and we can think for the betterment of a process. Then pressure contours are there. The distribution of pressure is quite important. Here you can see that there is 7 megapascals of pressure which is there, and it is a turbulent kinetic energy contour. All these are the crank angles at the TDC, at top dead center of the piston. Do's and don'ts in CFD. This is very important for every one of us. We have to look for do's and don'ts. Do's, let us first think of what are the important points that we have to do in learning CFD. Is have a command on the fundamental subjects. First of all, if anybody says that he is feeling difficulty in CFD, he is feeling difficulty with the mathematics. So therefore, the fundamental subjects which are there always should be very thoroughly analyzed for going into the CFD. Domain knowledge is very, very important. Domain knowledge of all the subjects is quite important. Numerical modeling techniques, the mathematics that has been involved in different mathematical modeling is quite important, and he should be able to know the boundary conditions, might be initial boundary conditions or might be the final boundary conditions of a particular problem. He has to be, and a realistic approach nearer to the practical approach is recommended rather than an animated approach. Generally, people have a wide varieties of animations in their mind, and they try to apply it onto the CFD, but it should be more realistic rather than a hypothetical and an animated approach. Command in any one programming language is a must. Let me tell you, the back-end programming of might be Fluent or might be Star CD, the commercially available packages, are we used to have a C language. The back-end program runs with the C language. And likewise, if you want to have a specific application and you want to append your own application, you can write a program in C language and you have to append to that particular CFD package. That particular flexibility is there. So depending on all the applications, you can write your own program and append it to the software, and you can get the results for your own application. This is the beauty of the computational fluid dynamics. And still now, few of the codes such as Kiva are still using Fortran program. Fortran, nowadays NASA entirely goes with the Fortran program. It is very difficult to hack the code. So therefore, majority nowadays people are not might be well versed with the Fortran. But in early 90s, we used to have the Fortran programming, because in our basic Gulbarga University, where we did our graduation, we used to have a basic and a Fortran language programming. So Fortran is a very ideal conditions. Still, it is being used in NASA. So one language is a must. So we synergize all this, a fundamental domain knowledge of mechanical engineering and one computer language, and we apply it for a CFD. And the only mechanical person can do this. This is the beauty of a mechanical engineer. Next, we go for don'ts in CFD. More focus on learning tool will eat away your time. So do not focus much on learning any tool. Today you have one tool in a market. Tomorrow you will have an advanced version of that particular tool. So learning tool is not the criteria. In the starting itself, I have said that learning tool is not at all the criteria. Because one day, it is continuously prone for a customization, because it goes on continuously changing. So acquire your skill only, you will acquire skill only by learning tool, you are wasting time. So if you doesn't know the fundamental knowledge of CFD and you are learning only a tool, it is as good as a garbage in and a garbage out. So do not go for that particular approach. It is highly deplorable. It is non-commendable that you go for operating simple tool without knowing the fundamental knowledge of computational fluid dynamics. Results and simulations of CFD codes are always questionable. As I already said that, do not take the results of simulations as authentic. Nobody will trust your simulated results. Everyone will put a question mark that whether these results are correct or not. This can be done only with the validation part and with the experimentation part. We can optimize the solution using a simulation, not we can come for the solution, exact solution using simulations. The exact solution that we can come only with is with respect to the experimentation only. Next, CFD is a promising future. CFD offers lot many job opportunities. As I have said that lot pay package is there for pre-processing, lot pay package is there in industry for solvers, and lot many pay package is there for a documentation and working for the fluent documentation, interpreting the results and producing user manuals and all those things. So therefore, I strongly ask you to have a fundamental knowledge such that you can attack in an interview that what fundamentally a pre-processor is. What is the solver, how it does the work, and what are the post processing of the results, how you present the results and all those things. So therefore, after learning these fundamental CFDs, you post your resume to the CFD forum. One forum is there which is called as a CFD forum, where you will be picked apart from Twitter and all those things. You will have a CFD forum which is quite important, where you put up the bio data as an expertise that you might have been learned, and you say that I am expert in gambit or in a meshing part or in a solution part. Then he will pick your bio data and you can get a call from the industry directly, where R&D, lot many expertise nowadays are needed, are required for R&D, because now there is a transition from diesel to the electric vehicles. Larger transition is there. Larger simulations are being done nowadays. There is hardly expertise available in the market, especially for CFD. Next, these are the commercial available softwares in CFD. We have Kiva Code. We have Fluent, StarCD, Autodesk CFD, SimulationX, OpenSource. All the above except open source software, open source is available for all, right? With the name of a open form, not necessary to purchase. This one, it is, as I have said, it is an open source. You can directly go into the open source, download it, and you can work for a smaller simulations. Before purchasing anything or before knowing more about the software, you can work for the simple solutions in, but complicated turbulence modeling and modeling of a higher end, you cannot go for using an open form. It is mandatory that you have to purchase the software if it is a complicated kind of an approach. Conclusions, you know, CFD proved to be an extremely important tool. Understanding the fundamentals of physics of a problem is very, very important. Drawing CAE model, meshing the geometry, importing the mesh model, all these are quite important. CFD is a growth industry. Unlimited new applications and new ideas just waiting for your future. These are conclusions that we can draw from this particular applications. Next is the important is the textbooks that are available for CFD, computational fluid dynamics by John D. Anderson. It is you need to purchase this over internet, or you can go for any libraries, either in IITs or NITs, you can find out this particular John D. Anderson. This is the fundamental book, which is beautifully presented, and you can directly go for purchasing it if you are interested in CFD. Next is, I have taken majority into from a majority of my slides from this particular textbook, which is an introduction to CFD by Warstig and Malalasekara. Next is computational fluid mechanics and heat transfer by Anderson, Telenal, Fletcher. And coming to S.P. Patankar, this is an Indian author, TMH publications, numerical and heat transfer fluid flow. Patankar is also good. And few figures I have chosen from Fluent documentation and StarCD documentation. These are the recommended kind of things for learning computational fluid dynamics. Next. Thank you. A lot of thanks to all of you for patience. And, any queries? If possible, I will. Let me check out the chat box. Now, one question is there, Pawan Kumara, he has asked this particular question. Sir, how reliable CFD output results if integrated in machine process? As I have said that no CFD results are reliable. Let me underline this fact. No CFD results are reliable. Don't rely on 100% CFD. It can give you only M.Tech degree. But if you go for higher degrees, especially for PhD or PDF, it is mandatory that you have to have a validation part. How we can put in solar cells? In simulating any solar voltaic cells, because solar panels can be simulated, not the this question was asked by please present last is just one I want to have the glance. Last 3 slides you will be ready. Go for last 3 slides. This was asked by Aparna. I'm just going back for last 3 slides. Conclusion part, CFD proved to be an extremely important tool and commercially available software. CFD, Kiva codes, RCD. Yeah. One question is from Mohammed Sami Dafedar. He said that, sir, which type of machine use converged solutions in less time? It depends on the domain of the particular which you have asked for meshing. If if you have a larger control volumes, it takes larger time for meshing. If you have lesser control volumes and the domain of the query, better you go a fine mesh and
Professor, is it audible?
Sir, is CFD used in nanotechnology? I said, not exactly nanotechnology. I am answering to Muhammad Nasir Ali, who has asked is CFD useful in nanotechnology. No, CFD is not being used in nanotechnology. Rather, it is being used in nanofluids, right? So one of my students is doing PhD in nanofluids. He has added few nano refrigerant and he has done for that also. So therefore, so for nanotechnology, yes, for nano fluids and nano refrigerants, CFD can be applied. Aparna is asking for presentation of I will discuss with organizers for the slides, madam. It has taken larger time to prepare. Aparna, I will get back to you later.
Okay.
Any further questions? I am open.
Professor, shall we go for some feedback, professor?
Yeah, please.
Hope the queries have finished. Hope so.
Yeah, I'm trying to answer majority of them. Is the result really for nano scale? Is the result rely for nano scale? Now we are interpreting the result, Mr. Nasir. I'm just interpreting the results now. We are in a part of into the nano scale results. I think we need a discussion on this. Is the result rely for nano scale?
I would like to extend many thanks to Professor Dr. Jamil Basha for enlightening delivery of speech regarding CFD. It was more than expectations. Professor, I hope you have given a lot of inputs for all the participants who are really aspirants. Definitely, they will be helpful. Hope all the candidates have enjoyed your session. And I'm really happy to say that you are my best friend and readily accepted to deliver this. I am very much thankful. It was a great session. It has been very long time that we are together. Hope for this platform has helped us to be in touch. Similarly, most of the people have gained a lot of knowledge regarding this CFA.
We will think regarding the slides, Professor Venkatramana. We will think it later.
If you permit, I will give you your mail ID. Okay.
We will discuss.
Yeah. Okay. Right. Right then. Okay. Now I ask the participants. Any of the participants can give some feedback.
Hello, sir. This is Professor Nasrali, Mohammad Nasrali speaking from Khwaja Bandnawaz College of Engineering, Kalburgi.
Okay. Gulbarga.
So I have attended all the sessions, all the 5 days.
Okay.
First of all, I would like to congratulate all the coordinators of BITM. Various expertise and these sessions were very informative, sir, very knowledgeable, and it covers all the research trends in thermal engineering, sir. Starting from the ICE, delivered by later on by various speakers, OD Abbal sir, yesterday's sessions by Dr. Abdul Razak sir, and this session by Jamil Basha sir. It was a very informative and very powerful session, sir. It covers from CFD, ICE engine, alternate fuels, all the things which are pertaining to the research trends in thermal engineering. Almost they have been covered by the speakers, sir. Very good to have all these speakers. We are really enjoy, as well as we have such more knowledge regarding these research related to the thermal, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Hello, sir.
Hello, sir.
Please, Mulimani, Dr. Mulimani. Yeah, please.
Hello, sir.
I'm Dr.
Hello. Yeah, go ahead.
Please. This Mulimani. Please kindly, Dr. Mulimani.
Yeah, I'm Dr. H.P. Mulimani from BGMI. For even all the 5 days, it was really exciting, and the attendees here, more attending this seminar was even the last day, even the strength now is around 100, it's around exactly 5. So this gives you a very good feedback. Really, I appreciate all the members. Really, like I see, sir, and the biodiesel, and today CFD by Jamal, sir.
Yeah.
It covers all the recent trends in thermal department. So it is very, very useful for these sessions. And the professors want to pursue their PhD. Many of what their PhD topics and going ahead. And we will give us a very good information. And I request to organize more such events. And it was a very and the topics and the organizer were very excellent. Yes. Important to specifically say. Thank you for all one another.
Yes, sir. Yes. Thank you very much, sir, Dr. Mulimani, sir. We are very honored. Thank you very much.
Hello.
Manjunath, yes, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for giving me an opportunity to speak. Sir, I have a question with Jamil, sir.
Yes, Manjunath, go ahead.
Sir, suppose if a problem is solved using an effluent and the same problem is solved in an open forum.
Okay.
So do we get the same answer from both of them, or it is quite comparable?
Absolutely not. If two persons use this Fluent only, let us suppose you are using Fluent and I am using Fluent, both of our answers will be different. Are you getting Manjunath Garu?
Yes sir.
Yeah, if both of us use the same commercial code Fluent, then both of us have a different solution. Not even one solution, you can compare. You are telling about the different. It is an open source and it is a confined software. You cannot get the solution. The accuracy of the solution cannot be checked right like this.
Thank you, sir. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Anybody would like to give some feedback, sir? Anybody? Vardini, sir.
This is from Vardini from Uttaragandhi Polytechnic. All the questions are very good, sir. Very informative questions. Thermodynamics is a very vast subject. As long as we are go in depth, we can learn more and more in the thermodynamic matter. Thanks to all the resource persons. Thanks to BITM College. They have organized a very good LDP program on the thermodynamics, and we request to do all such this type of FTP programs in future also. We are liking to join in these FTP programs, and I thank you all, sir.
Yeah, thank you, ma'am. Thank you for the kind feedback. Hope the time is up, ma'am. I would like to extend thanks from our BITM team, especially mechanical engineering department, and our directors, Yashwant Gopal sir, Director Prithviraj sir, Principal V.C. Patil, our HOD Edwally Baswaraj, Professor Dr. Raghavendra Joshi, myself Dr. Venkat Ramna, and my team, Janmati, and Manjunath, then Pawan B.S., etc., Ravi. All these things, we extend sincere thanks to one and all for participating in this event. Send thanks and congratulations to everybody. Hope these sessions are useful for you people. I would like to conclude now. Thank you. Thank you, everyone and all. Professor, Speaker, Dr. Jamil, sir, thank you very much. It's an honor speaking with you.
Thank you, sir.
I will conclude, sir, now. Over and over. Okay? Right, sir. Thank you.
Oh. Leave meeting.